Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Last week I received an email from someone wondering how to use the Affinity Photo Gradient Tool. He wanted to use it to create a neutral density filter effect in the photo persona by drawing a gradient. Whilst the Affinity Develop persona includes an overlay tool for this, there are benefits from being able to use the gradient tool in the photo persona. For example, it can be used after developing the raw file if you realise the exposure balance isn't quite right. But you can also use it to adjust the image colour at the same time. In this video, I'll be looking at how to achieve both of these things using a simple gradient and blending modes in the photo persona. This is the landscape photo we'll be editing. As you can see, the foreground rocks are quite dark, whilst the sky is a little too light. I'll start by adding a new fill layer to the image using the Layers menu. This adds a new layer to the image which is filled with a solid colour. It also activates the gradient tool in the tools palette, which we'll be using to draw our gradient. At this point, before we draw the gradient, we can change the background colour of the layer using the colour swatch. This allows me to demonstrate the effect of the multiply blending mode using a white background. When I change the blending mode of the layer to multiply, you'll see that the white layer vanishes. That's because white is what we call the neutral colour. The neutral colour of a blending mode is one that doesn't cause a change to the image. But watch what happens if I change the white to a dark grey. It darkens the image. And the darker the grey, the darker the image becomes until eventually it turns black. If you look at the blending mode drop-down list, you can see that it's divided into groups. The top group all darken the image in some way, but each produces a slightly different result. They also all have white as their neutral colour, whereas for other blending modes it might be grey or black. Now we know this, we can use the information to draw our gradient using the gradient tool. I'll just return the layer to the normal blending mode so that you can see the gradient when I draw it. With the gradient tool selected, I can see its controls in the Affinity Context Sensitive toolbar. Here I want to set the context to be fill so that the gradient fills the layer with the colour I set. We can then also set the type of gradient we want to draw. As this will mimic a neutral density graduated filter, we want to use a linear gradient. You can also use the same technique to draw out a vignette using a radial or elliptical gradient. Now we need to set the colour of the gradient by clicking on the colour swatch and selecting the gradient tab. This is where we can define the gradient and the colour we want to use. On the left we have the gradient starting colour and on the right the finishing colour. To set the colour, click the endpoint and then click the colour swatch in the dialog. In this example, let's start with a dark grey by setting the red, green and blue sliders to 50. Because all three of these colours have the same value, it produces grey. I can then select the other end of the gradient and set that colour to white. The line in the centre controls the blending of the gradient between the two ends. Having defined the gradient, I can draw it onto the fill layer. Notice the colour above my starting point becomes the dark grey we defined. Then below the end point of the gradient, the colour is white. This produces a uniform gradient between the two colours. But if I click the centre point, I can drag it along the gradient line to control the gradient blending. Now, even though we've picked our colours and drawn the gradient, we can still change them. If I click the starting point of the gradient to select it, I can then change the colour in the Colour Studio panel. The panel has several ways to represent colour, which you can access in a drop-down list. Because we want to use grey in our example, the easiest way to change it is using the grayscale option. With the colour point selected, I can move the grayscale slider left and right to change the shade of grey. If you decide to use the grayscale adjustment, do remember that it's showing the percentage value of white in the colour. Setting it to 50 doesn't produce the same shade of grey as when we used the RGB sliders earlier. They're using a value range from 0 to 255. You can see this if I change the colour panel to show the RGB controls. Now let's change the blending mode from normal to multiply. This darkens the top part of the image where we set the colour to grey. But it doesn't have any effect on the lower part of the image where the gradient was white. Unfortunately, the blending mode we've chosen has left the image looking a little flat, and there are some better options. One of these is the color burn, which produces more intense color as well as darkening the image. The default settings look terrible, but there are a few simple changes we can make to improve things. The first of these is possibly the most obvious and is reducing the opacity of the layer to reduce the strength of the effect. The second is that we can change the blending range of the layer to control how it blends with the layers below it. When I click the cog icon at the top of the layer panel, it opens the blending range dialog. If I don't want the layer to affect the dark area of the sky, I can move this point on the left down. I might also add other points which I can then position to control the effect. If you're unsure how to use the blending range controls, I've published a couple of videos which explain them. I'll include the links in the YouTube video information for this video. The other change we can make is to the color. So far we've been blending with grey because that doesn't change the hue of the image color. But perhaps the image would look better if we did adjust the hue. We can do this by selecting the top point of the gradient and then changing it with the RGB color controls. Now we can modify the individual color channels. This shifts the color of the image when we're using the color burn blending mode. We can also change the lower color of the gradient to fine-tune the overall color balance of the image. After adjusting the blending ranges and color balance, you may want to tweak the layer opacity again. Now, everything I've explained in this video is based around a simple technique of using gradient tool with blending modes. It's extremely powerful and you can control it using four variables. There is the color used in the gradient, the layer opacity, the blending ranges control, and of course the blending mode of the layer. Experiment with these and you can create some extremely powerful editing effects. I hope you found today's video helpful. If you have, please take a moment to share it with other Affinity users. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you soon for another video.